3406.
Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to measure some antennas, the ones that we find usually inside the radios, the rubber ducky ones, like this one for instance, or this one here. You can find one or two in every radio that you buy, and we don't actually know if they're good or how good they are. So I got my nano VNA here, just made a table to take some measurements down. I'm going to pause the video, make the measurements and present them to you. I just wanted to show this in the nano VNA. As you can see here, I have some adapters to connect my antenna, but in order to measure those antennas, it's not easy since they are essentially a monopole. There's no dipole for the nano VNA to measure. So I made what we call a counterpoise. This is just wire measured for VHF, UHF, about, to act as the second part of the dipole. This, as you can see here, is connected to the ground, and it's going to be connected to the ground of the antenna, and the nano VNA can take some measurements close to what we want to see in VHF and UHF. So I'm going to make the measurements now, fill in the table, and we'll see it in the PC and see the results.
Okay, so I did the measurements with the nano VNA in those antennas, and let's see the results. Right, here I have some screenshots from the nano VNA and the table with the measurements I will show you at the end. Let's pass them over quickly. This is the VHF for the Diamond RH771 antenna. It's an original antenna. The UHF, this is the Quansheng rubber antenna. Again, UHF here. The tape measure, no name antenna, and here in VHF. The rubber antenna that was in the Tidradio H3, and here in UHF. The Wouxun antenna, the one of the two that were inside the Wouxun radio, or Evolt, the ATQ332, and here in UHF. And here's the table. Let's see that for a moment. So, here are the measurements. As you can see, I have marked the SWR, and in wet megahertz, it dropped at the minimum point. The worst was the one that was in the Tidradio H3. As you can see, the drop here was at 136,600 megahertz and 1.7 SWR. And also here we had the problem in the 70 centimeter band. So to recap, I just have to say one more thing, that some of the rubber antennas that were included in the handheld radios, probably they were tuned also for airband or 200 megahertz. And maybe this is why we see the megahertz move to a certain direction. Then again, the SWR is kind of high, so I would say that the Wouxun one that was in the KGQ332 or Evolt ETQ332 was kind of the best performance in the rubber area of antennas. But of course, as you can see, this is why everyone that is experienced says throw them away and go and buy an original antenna for VHF, UHF for 2 meters and 7 centimeters, and you don't have to look back. See the performance here of the Diamond RH771, it's amazing. 1.03 SWR in 140-700 megahertz and 1.3 at 430. What else would you want? So this is the difference from a commercial good quality antenna to the rubber duckies that are given with the handheld radios. Of course, that doesn't mean that you can't carry one around. I carry the one from Wouxun, which has the best performance of those. The Diamond antenna is sometimes kind of big for my backpack. It's flexible, but I just don't want to break it. I hope that in a video real soon we're gonna make another one, a homemade portable antenna, and we'll test it and see how it performs. So this was a quick video with measurements for the rubber ducky antennas and the excellent Diamond RH771. Just be careful if you search to buy one of those Diamonds or the Nagoyas in US, be careful to buy an original one. It's not easy. Sometimes a lot of them are sold as originals, they're not. And if you find a 771 antenna that costs about 10 euros, 5 euros, 6 euros or something about that, or dollars, stay away, stay clear, it's probably fake. The original Diamond RH771 here in Europe costs about 25 to 30 euros, and I imagine the Nagoyas cost about the same in US. Always buy from a legitimate shop that has amateur radio equipment, and be careful for the antenna to be the original one. Thank you for watching this quick video. I hope you found it interesting. Please subscribe to my channel and see you next time.